or a special gift that makes him to a superhero. And Bionic Man, it's like a weakness turning into a superpower. And we created like cartoons for children, and that's what's all about Bionic Man, to give self-confidence to children with no limbs, with no hands, with no legs, and to integrate them in the story. And of course, children with both hands, with both legs, to sensibilize that children, they are like different people, they are like blind people, people in wheelchairs, and they are not like different than others, and to build bridges between those two people groups, I would say. And then I started a tour in schools, in hospitals, and in rehabilitation centers for children with Bionic Man. And we thought, oh, we have to create a Bionic Man costume. And I have two good friends. They do normally costumes for TV production. Well, highly professional. And I told them, let's do a Bionic Man costume. And they say, oh, yes, let's do it. And it would look like this when I'm Bionic Man in school with the children. And it's like a kind of magical moment. It's like a Mickey Mouse moment when children, for example, go to Disneyland. They thought, oh, look, that's Mickey Mouse. They thought, they do not think, oh, that's just a student under this costume. They think that's Mickey Mouse in the Disneyland. And it's like Bionic Man the same. When I go to schools, of course, they are like little children around 5 or 7 years old. They think, wow, that's Bionic Man on the cartoon. And it's like a magical moment for them.